Computer and Information Systems Manager. What do Computer and Information Systems Managers do? Computer and Information Systems Managers, often called Information Technology, IT, Managers or IT Project Managers, plan, coordinate, and direct computer-related activities in an organization. They help determine the information technology goals of an organization and are responsible for implementing computer systems to meet those goals. Duties: Computer and Information Systems Managers typically do the following. Analyze their organization's computer needs and recommend possible upgrades for top executives to consider. Plan and direct the installation and maintenance of computer hardware and software. Ensure the security of an organization's network and electronic documents. Assess the costs and benefits of new projects and justify funding on projects to top executives. Learn about new technology and look for ways to upgrade their organization's computer systems. Determine short and long-term personnel needs for their department. Plan and direct the work of other IT professionals, including computer systems analysts, software developers, information security analysts, and computer support specialists. Negotiate with vendors to get the highest level of service for the organization's technology. Few managers carry out all of these duties. There are various types of computer and information systems managers, and the specific duties of each are determined by the size and structure of the firm. Smaller firms may not employ every type of manager. The following are examples of types of computer and information systems managers. Chief Information Officers, CIO, determine an organization's technology or information goals and then oversee technology implementation to meet those goals. CIO may focus on a specific area, such as electronic data processing or information systems, but CIO tend to focus on long-term or significant picture issues. A CIO has more direct control over the IT department at small organizations. At larger organizations, other managers under the CIO may handle the day-to-day activities of the IT department. CIO who do not have the technical expertise and focus solely on a company's business aspects are included in top executives. Chief Technology Officers, CTOs, evaluate new technology and determine how it can help their organization. When both CIO and CTO are present, the CTO usually has more technical expertise. The CTO usually reports directly to the CIO and is responsible for designing and recommending the appropriate technology solutions to support the CIO policies and directives. CTO also work with different departments to implement the organization's technology plans. When a company does not have a CIO, the CTO determines the overall technology strategy for the firm and presents it to top executives. IT directors, including Management Information Systems, MIS directors, oversee their organization's information technology departments, and they directly supervise other employees. IT directors help determine the business requirements for IT systems and implement the top executives' policies. IT directors often have a direct role in hiring members of the IT department. Their job is to ensure data and network services by coordinating IT activities. IT directors also oversee the financial aspects of their department, such as budgeting. IT security managers oversee their organization's network and data security. They work with top executives to plan security policies and promote an information security culture throughout the organization. They develop programs to keep employees aware of security threats. These managers must keep up to date on IT security measures. They also supervise investigations if there is a security violation. Work environment. Computer and Information Systems Managers held about 482,000 jobs in 2020. The largest employers of Computer and Information Systems Managers were as follows. Computer systems design and related services account for 22%. Finance and insurance account for 12%. Information technology companies account for 11%. Management of companies and enterprises account for 9%. And manufacturing account for 6%. Work schedules. Most computer and information systems managers work full-time. If problems arise, managers may need to work more than 40 hours a week to develop solutions. and systems manager. Typically, a bachelor's degree in computer or information science, plus related work experience is required. Many computer and information systems managers also have a graduate degree. Education. Computer and information systems managers typically need a bachelor's degree in computer and information technology or a related field, such as engineering technologies. These degrees include courses in computer programming, software development, and mathematics. Management information systems, MIS, programs usually include business classes and computer-related ones. Many organizations require their computer and information systems managers to graduate degrees. A Master of Business Administration, MBA, is standard and takes 2 years beyond the undergraduate level to complete. Many people are pursuing an MBA to take classes while working, an option that can increase the time required to complete that degree. Work experience in a related occupation. Most computer and information systems managers' jobs require several years of experience in related information technology jobs. Lower-level management positions may require only a few years of experience. Directors are more likely to need 5 to 10 years of related work experience. A chief technology officer, who oversees the technology plan for a large organization, may need more than 15 years of experience in the IT field before being considered for a job. The number of years of experience required varies with the organization. Generally, smaller or newer companies do not require as much experience as larger or more established ones. Computer systems are used throughout the economy, and IT employees may gain experience in various industries. However, an applicant's work experience should be in the same industry they are applying to work in. For example, an IT security manager should have previously worked in information security. A hospital IT director should have experience in the healthcare field. Advancement. Most computer and information systems managers start as lower-level managers and advance to higher positions within the IT department. IT directors or project managers can advance to become CTO. A CTO's or other manager who is significantly business-minded can advance to become a chief information officer in charge of all IT-related decisions in an organization. CIO can advance to become top executives in an organization. Important qualities: analytical skills, business skills, communication skills, decision-making skills, leadership skills, organization skills. Pay. The median annual wage for computer and information systems managers was $151,150 in May 2020. The median wage is when half the workers in an occupation earned more than that amount and half earned less. The lowest 10% earned less than $90,430, and the highest 10% earned more than $208,000. In May 2020, the median annual wages for computer and information systems managers in the top industries in which they worked were as follows. Information technology companies $166,770. Computer systems design and related services $157,580. Finance and insurance $155,760. Management of companies and enterprises $152,480. Manufacturing $150,930. Most computer and information systems managers work full-time. If problems arise, managers may need to work more than 40 hours a week to develop solutions. The median annual wage for computer and information systems managers was $151,150 in May 2020. The median wage is when half the workers in an occupation earned more than that amount and half earned less. The lowest 10% earned less than $90,430, and the highest 10% earned more than $208,000. Job outlook. The employment of computer and information systems managers is projected to grow 11% from 2020 to 2030, faster than the average for all occupations. About 42,400 openings for computer and information systems managers are projected each year on average over the decade. Many of those openings are expected to result from the need to replace workers who transfer to different occupations or exit the labor force, such as retire. deployment. As firms expand their operations to digital platforms, demand for computer and information systems managers will grow. Computer and information systems managers will be responsible for implementing these goals. Employment growth will result from the need to bolster cybersecurity and computer and information systems used by businesses. Industries such as retail trade will need to implement more robust security policies as cyber threats increase. An increase in the popularity of cloud computing may result in firms outsourcing services from in-house IT departments to cloud computing companies. This will shift IT services from IT departments in non-computer industries, such as financial firms or schools, to firms engaged in computer systems design and related services and data processing, hosting, and related services.